Thank you. Could I ask those who are leaving the chamber to please do so quickly and quietly as we are about to move to our next item of business. Thank you. And the next item of business is a member's business debate on motion 12187 in the name of Christine Graham on congratulating Christo FM Penicuik as the best community radio broadcaster at the SME News Scottish Enterprise Awards. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put, and I would ask those members who would wish to speak in the debate to please press the request to speak buttons, and I call on Christine Graham to open the debate. Ms Graham.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer. It's a pleasure to speak, and not for the first time, on the importance of community radio. This debate, as you've said, focuses on Crystal FM, located in Penicuik in my constituency, and in particular on the success of the station winning the Best Community Broadcaster Award for the second time. I visited the studio recently, and very professional it is too, and met up with Colin McCall, the anchor man, and a man who has devoted his time to the good of Penicuik over decades, first campaigning with him to save Jackson Street facilities years ago. Unfortunately, that was a battle lost, but you can't keep a good man down. So we had a good long chat about all the station does and some of its issues, which I'll come to, as well as more about Colin. Launched on 1st December 2013, it's run by volunteers, broadcasting over South Midlothian, Edinburgh and the Lothians, as well as to listeners all over the world via the internet. With over 50 presenters and information providers involved, it has non-stop 24/7 output and is an important part of the community, but depends on donations and subscriptions. Simply to survive, it has to raise £12,000 annually and has overcome setbacks over the years. Flooded studios, a move to temporary accommodation for a period of 6 months, and then when COVID appeared, required to move to other premises to ensure the studios were COVID compliant. As a result, it went from its temporary accommodation to a permanent home in the Eastfield Business Centre in Penicuik. So the radio service has been maintained, meaning that youngsters from Penny High, Beeslack High School, Peebles and Lasswade High Schools can continue to participate in the service, gaining hands-on experience in all aspects of broadcasting, thereby developing skills, confidence and self-esteem. These committed volunteers ensure the smooth running and scheduling of programmes. They do outreach work with individuals who are housebound and encourage others to visit the studios to participate in discussion and learn new skills and to allow spells away from their home isolation. In particular, older members of the community enjoy the autonomy in the creation of their own shows and the community engagement involved, thus giving them that good feel factor, enhancing mental health. Individuals with special needs are catered for, including two with physical handicaps and an individual who is autistic and one who suffers from Asperger's. Now to funding, a constant worry, but supported by 12 businesses classified as proud supporters of Crystal FM and numerous individuals who also pledge support with regular and frequent financial pledges and numerous donations received from others from time to time. The Crystal FM Radio Club provides financial support via membership fees, but outlays are substantial. Ofcom, £6,000. Wireless and telegraphy, £2,500, these over a 10-year period. Music licensing fees to PPL, PRS, MCPS, £30,000. VAT payments made in excess of £25,000 over the 10 years. And that is a particular cruel levy on this local service, which is not a business and therefore cannot apply to be VAT registered as it doesn't have income levels. VAT is reserved to Westminster, but I do put some point, something can be done for these organisations when they have these VAT burdens to carry. More actually from a really good website they have. It has well over 110,000 hits on the website, and now with over 50 presenters and information providers involved, as I've said, in 24-hour a day, 7 days a week output. Back to Colin McCall, station coordinator, former primary school teacher, now in his 80th year, but like me, he's flourishing. He founded the station, which was shortlisted for a community award in last year's Midlothian East Lothian Chamber of Commerce Awards, with a handful of other enthusiasts who donated £100 each. And a quote from Colin: Crystal FM came to fruition because Black Diamond, brackets in Newton Grange, was not receivable over here in Penicuik. I forwarded an application of Ofcom to extend the area to Penicuik, and they refused. They did, however, say they looked favourably on a Penicuik application. Six or seven of us put £100 on the table, and 18 months later, Crystal FM came about. This is the start of our 11th year, and we have a great team of volunteers who have made that possible. Close quotes. Overall, the station reach is supposed to be 6 miles from the studio in Eastfield Business Centre in Eastfield Farm Road in Penicuik. But as Colin says, quotes, how do you stop a radio signal? It's variable. You can go a very short distance and the signal is lost, or you go a long distance and pick up the signal. For example, I've picked up the signal from the golf course car park in Kirkcaldy. Don't know what he was doing there. And it's excellent quality in the car. But our signal also reaches Rathaw near Edinburgh, so it must go through a gap in the Pentland Hills. Isn't that intriguing? Continuing the quote, we now stream out online, and it's interesting to note that since we moved to our new studio more than 2 years ago, we now have over 100,000 hits on our website. Continuing the quotes, looking further afield, on the internet, our broadcasts are worldwide, and our regular top four online are the UK, USA, Europe, and India. We also have listeners in Australia. I don't really know why we have listeners in India, he says, but it may possibly be a link to the people who live there, and it allows their relatives to listen. But India has always figured in the top three or four, close quotes. And there's a wee exercise for somebody. Find out why India listens to Crystal FM. Good stuff, Colin. Finally, Deputy Presiding Officer, I commend all who work at Crystal FM, the volunteers, the donors and the listeners who make it all worthwhile. And I wish them many more decades ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms Graham. I now call Claire Hockey to be followed by Craig Hoy. Ms Hockey.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I would like to congratulate Christine Graham on securing today's debate, and I too pay tribute to Crystal FM based in the Members' constituency for winning the Best Community Radio Broadcaster Award. Community radio stations provide a voice for our local communities, and for my speech today, I want to highlight and celebrate one of the UK's 300 licensed community radio stations, Cam Glen Radio, which is based in my constituency. Cam Glen Radio, as the name suggests, primarily serves the areas of Cambuslang and Rutherglen in my constituency, as well as surrounding localities, broadcasting on 107.9 FM locally and worldwide online. Part of the brilliant local third sector organisation Healthy and Happy Community Development Trust, Cam Glen Radio has broadcast since 2007 and became a full-time service in 2015. As it says on their website, the station's purpose is to address inequality and improve well-being. And they do this through supporting local people to be active and involved by providing media training and skill building as a pathway to employment and by using radio to connect people and communities. Presiding Officer, on that last point, community radio play a crucial role in fostering a sense of belonging and connection amongst its listeners. At a time when radio is dominated by large media conglomerates, which are more focused on regional, national or global news, community radio stations very often tell the stories of local significance that wouldn't be picked up elsewhere. Cam Glen Radio offers a variety of programming, including music spanning different genres, talk shows covering local news, history and events, and speciality programmes catering to specific interests within the community. But not only that, the radio station provides local people with vital opportunities and experiences. Cam Glen Radio helps the volunteers develop their radio skills, covering all aspects of radio operations from planning and presenting shows through to editing, production and broadcast support. Whether it's learning how to host a radio show, produce compelling stories or operate technical equipment, community radio stations play a vital role in nurturing the next generation of broadcasters and journalists within our communities, or even providing local people with transferable skills to take into whatever career path they choose. Since starting, Camglen Radio have given the opportunity to local primary and secondary schools to take over the airways and produce their own shows. Some of the schools in my constituency that have made content on Camglen Radio over the years include Newton Farm, James Zayton, St Brides, Hallside, Borough, Bankhead, Calderwood, Cairns, St Mark's and St Anthony's Primaries, as well as Rutherglen, Cathkin and Trinity High Schools. And two of my own sons took great pride and pleasure in presenting shows with their classmates from St Columb Hills Primary School some years ago. Presiding officer, community radio, like local newspapers, connect people to the stories in a way that national media cannot. People may feel that articles and stories are abstract, and they may feel disconnected if the issues at hand aren't local to them. And community radio stations like Camglen Radio ground stories within the heart of the communities they serve. One of my constituents, Dr. Janice Ross, wrote her doctoral thesis on community radio, the first person to do so in the country. And Janice is currently interviewing local refugee women whom she's met and befriended through her local volunteering to learn more about their experiences, their journeys to these shores, and how they have adapted to life in Scotland. This series of programmes will provide a unique personal, social and political history archive and will be broadcast on the radio station in the coming months. This highlighting of an amplification of diverse local voices is what makes Camglen Radio what it is and why community radio is much loved across Scotland. Presiding officer, I too have had the pleasure of being on Camglen Radio a couple of times over the years, the first of which was when I was interviewed by the late Bob Rowett just before the 2016 election. Bob was Rutherglen and Cambus Lang's answer to Jeremy Paxman, having hosted many local political hustings that Camglen Radio broadcast. He was a very astute interviewer and kept many local candidates on their toes. Camglen Radio, like so many other community radio stations, play a vital role in our democratic process, promoting informed decision-making amongst voters and holding us politicians to account. In concluding, Presiding Officer, I would like to again thank Christine Graham for securing today's debate. And I'm sure that Camglen Radio will give Crystal Radio a run for their money at next year's awards ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Hockey. I call Craig Hoy to be followed by Faisal Chaudhry. Mr Hoy.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. And I'd like to echo those thanks to Christine Graham for bringing forward this important debate. Like Ms Graham, I would like to add my wholehearted congratulations to all the volunteers at Crystal FM on winning the Best Community Radio Broadcaster Award at the SME News Scottish Enterprise Awards for the second year running, and for the energy that they bring to doing so, and the energy that the member has brought to the debate today. The award recognises the innovation, excellence and dedication that the volunteers bring to providing the best and most outstanding services to clients and customers. And it's crystal clear to me that Crystal FM does truly represent the very best of community radio. And as Christine Graham said, the station has been operating for the past 11 years, providing a service for the people of Penicuik, the surrounding area and the world, thanks to Alexa. And given that I've got friends and family in India, I will set about trying to find out why there are so many tuning in from there. Obviously, Penicuik Community Education Association, as a licensee of Crystal FM, ensures that this important community broadcasting service continues principally for the local area. And I'm alert to the funding concerns that the member has raised, and I hope that the minister, recognising however tight the creative budget is in Scotland, would look to see what he can do to support the directors and volunteers right across Scotland who deliver community radio services. I will, certainly.
Christine Graham.
I don't know if there's a solution to this, to say to the member, but do you agree with me that it's rather tough that they have to pay such substantial amounts in VAT, and simply because they're not an income-generating business, they can't even apply to register? And I wonder if, with his strong communication, I'm sure, with his colleagues at Westminster, he might be able to pursue this.
Craig Hoy.
I absolutely will. I've already suggested to the Treasury that they should be cutting VAT for our hard-pressed hospitality businesses here in Scotland, so I'm happy to add our community radio services to those discussions. Now, obviously, the Crystal FM service benefits hugely from the support of local businesses, patrons, listeners, friends and volunteers, and it's their unwavering assistance and commitment that ensures that it can continue to serve members of the local community with a broadcasting service which provides, as Christine Graham also said, hands-on training, inclusion lifelong learning and information. And as someone who went to Lasswade High, it was good to hear that those that are followed in my footsteps at that vulnerable institution are also getting access to radio services as well. Now, the radio station also doesn't just cover local issues, it raises greater awareness of global and national events. And if, obviously, you're on your way to work, as many of us are, and you're being held up at Sheriff Hall roundabout, it's good to hear that Colin McCall will keep you updated on just how long you might be held at that roundabout. Colin, as Christine Graham said, is now in his 80th year and is a former primary school teacher who founded the station. And I'd like to express our gratitude to him, because we know that it needs somebody at the centre to drive these community initiatives forward. And obviously, if you like rock and metal, Snoddy Mark Snodgrass, his show is on at 10 p.m. on Wednesday nights, and that will keep you rocking long after my bedtime. And if you would like to rather listen to folk music, then Johnny Ward presents Pentland Folk on a Thursday and Saturday afternoon. Deputy Presiding Officer, I am a huge fan of community and local radio, not least because it was in community and local radio that I cut my teeth journalistically. It was on Edinburgh University's Student FM that I took to the microphone for the first time, presenting a late-night cooking programme without any of the supporting materials in order to narrate how to make a luxury omelette on a student budget. I didn't even have a spoon or a stove in the studio, but my mother still believed that I'd actually managed to rustle up a late-night lobster omelette. I doubt that any listeners tried to make it, and in fact, I doubt there were many listeners at all, but it was a good place to make early journalistic mistakes. And I had more luck at Radio 4, where I learnt at the knee of the great David Johnson, the then news editor, or Dial David, as he was known. And I used to marvel when I was working on a Sundays on his Sunday call-in show, when Tam from Linlithgow would religiously dial in, and then the unmistakable voice of Tam Dyle from Linlithgow would then boom out to our listeners. David is no longer on our radios, but it's nice to see him frequently in East Lothian as a trustee and honorary flagmaster of the Saltire Heritage Centre in Aylesford. Deputy Presiding Officer, local and community radio stations have been and will continue, even in the digital age, to remain an important part of our communities. So, for example, in East Lothian, we see Radio Saltire and East Coast FM all broadcasting to residents. And a quick glance at Crystal FM's website and Facebook page confirms the important role that it is providing within Penicuik and much further afield, promoting local events, upcoming shows, local football, rugby, cricket team wins, draws and occasionally losses. So I once again congratulate all at Crystal FM for the important work that they are doing to share news and in entertaining listeners. The award is well deserved, and long may their success continue.
Thank you, Mr. Hoy. And I now call Faisal Chowdhury to be followed by Jamie Green. Mr. Chowdhury.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. I began by congratulating both Christian Graham on bringing this motion to the Chamber and the Crystal FM on winning the award for Best Community Radio Broadcast at the SME News Scottish Enterprise Awards for the second year running. A station that came to be when Ofcom refused to extend the signal of another. It is a true do-it-yourself story to be proud of. With over 50 presenters and 24/7 programming, it is impressive how Crystal FM have been able to mobilise the community to make this project a success. It is a great achievement and reflective of the dedication of everyone who gave their time to this station. Community radio stations such as Crystal FM are great in helping people of all ages develop new skills, like my colleague Craig Hoy. meet new people and increase their confidence. And this belief is held by Scots too. A 2012 Scottish Government review of community radio found 49% of people saying it was important to have a community radio station in their area. As other members will know, Crystal FM was formed when a handful of volunteers donated £100 each. As most community stations are run on the goodwill of their volunteers and donations, they're free from the commercial influences. This freedom lets communities create programming which truly represent them. It also allows for a wider variety of programming, with Crystal FM broadcasting shows containing reggae and run rig. And with the internet, the barrier to entry for new stations has never been lower. Independent stations such as Crystal FM should be welcomed. They give communities the opportunity for self-expression and foster arts and culture across Scotland. Community radio is also active in Lothian with stations such as EHFM and Black Diamond FM. Indeed, Black Diamond FM's work experience scheme for high school pupils are an example of how community stations can do great work for their local area. EHFM also celebrated its 5-year anniversary last year. They allow local artists to submit their music to be played on the station, further developing the city's music scene and Edinburgh's status as a cultural hub. It is clear that community stations do great work in helping people develop new skills and foster culture across Scotland. I reiterate my congratulations to all who have worked to bring this award to Crystal FM. They have created something very special. I wish them all the best in the future broadcast and look forward to turning on. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chowdhury, and I call Jamie Green. Mr. Green.
Thank you. Members will forgive me, I wasn't scheduled to speak in this debate, so I'm going to subject you to one of my, I wrote it during FMQ speeches, but I felt this was a really important debate to participate in, no least because I have a huge personal interest in local and community radio. I want to thank Christine Graham for bringing this motion to us, to commend Crystal FM on their achievement. We've heard a little bit more about some of the other community radio stations that are thriving in our communities, not despite and in face of the many challenges that they have. Of course, it would be remiss of me not to use this opportunity to plug some of my own community radio stations. I know the Cabinet Secretary is fully expecting me to do so, because he will refer to him in his closing comments, I know this. To Clyde Coast Radio out of Port Glasgow, and I know he loves this station because their local MP, Ronnie Cowan, has a resident slot on the station. Alas, they're yet to ring me, but I'm very welcome to come and do a show if they want me to. But what's really interesting is that when, obviously, technology means they're broadcasting on FM, but being able to broadcast online does open your reach right across the world. In fact, they have listeners in New Zealand, Canada, Spain and France, amongst other countries. Of course, some of that is diaspora. It will be Greenock and Clyde residents or their relatives who want to know what's going on in the local communities. And that really reiterates the importance of it. You know, for example, the Greenock Telegraph local newspaper is read by people all over the world. They have subscribers across the globe. Well, so is the case, too, of local radio. I'm really surprised to hear that we do harbour our own very own Julia Child here in the chamber, who took to the radio waves to teach people how to cook. Thank goodness they couldn't see the products of that effort. Thanks, such is the nature of radio, or indeed the taste.
Mr. Green, could I remind all members of the need to treat each other with courtesy and with respect?
And apologies to Julia Child for the reference in that respect. But I'd really want to make some important points about community radio. There are over 300 community radio stations operating across the UK. Many have tried and failed over the years for some of the reasons that have been quite eloquently illustrated. My own personal experience takes me right back to being a teenager when I got involved in local radio. I was very heavily involved in hospital radio, which also still thrives to an extent. And Inverclyde Royal Hospital Radio, it was my starting point for a career in media and broadcast. I did work experience in a number of local radio stations, and I remember our first local community radio station, which was Tall Ships FM in 1999, which was a short-term licence station off the back of a very big and successful local event, which attracted tens of thousands of visitors to Greenock. But that inspiration, running around chasing after people with a microphone, sitting there in front of a red light, knowing that you have to speak, otherwise silence is your death, was very much an inspiration, and it really gave me the motivation to seek more formal education and experience as my career moved on into radio and then into television as well. So it really is a starting point that can input and ingrain in young people the inspiration that they need, that this is something you can do. Anyone from any background can sit in front of a microphone and with the right experience make a success and a career out of it, and many people do. But the challenges they face are plenty. There is a consultation undergoing at the moment. Ofcom are looking at new ways of licensing this. There have been various models over the years. Some I think have been quite successful. Various grants have been available over the years, but it's never enough. It often relies on to be able to commercialise in any way you can through small local advertising or through philanthropy or indeed through other funding natures such as the National Lottery and the Postcode Lottery, who've also helpfully funded many of these. But I do hope that Ofcom will be looking carefully at how they make licensing appropriate, how they make it easy and accessible, and also how we take and make better use of new technologies to reach wider audiences as well. It's a very difficult landscape. All local radio has gone through a very difficult time of the last 20 years. That consolidation of networks, that reducing of bigger private ownership has taken out a lot of local news production. The same is true of local television as well and local news gathering. So these are many common issues that they face. But what I hope is that both governments will look at any way they can, whether it is the VAT issue, whether it's grant funding, whether it's Ofcom licensing regimes, whether it's how we can invest the skills and technology in those communities. Because I want to see that community station network thrive and survive and not have to face the fierce competition of the very well-funded large networks or indeed the public service broadcasters who seem to have bottomless pits of money to produce and pay their presenters. These are all run by volunteers. You should never forget that. People give up their time to educate their local communities, and the local communities that really rely on the local news, the charitable organisations that are often on, and of course to listen to some good music and good chat and banter, as we've heard, and anyone that's ever listened to Sonny Govan in Glasgow will know that the banter really is fantastic. So I want to thank Kristen Gillam for this very short debate. And I really do hope that if we have this debate in the future, we'll have far more community radio stations to praise and talk about. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Green. And I now invite Cabinet Secretary Angus Robertson to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please, Cabinet Secretary.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. And I'd like to thank Christine Graham for bringing this motion to the Parliament this afternoon, and to all of those from across the Chamber who've contributed on a subject that is close to my heart as a former radio broadcaster by profession. So thank you very much to all colleagues for their contributions, to Claire Hawkey, to Craig Hoy, to Faisal Chowdhury, to Jamie Green. And I'm sure I speak on behalf of every member of the Chamber when I say that I'd be very grateful if Craig Hoy would share a link to his Edinburgh University cookery programme. I'm sure we'd all enjoy listening to that. I agree with all members that community radio stations play an important part in the social fabric of Scotland. Community radio has an important role in the lives of its listeners, and it creates a sense of connection to others in their community. It promotes local activity and it encourages engagement. Its enduring importance in Scotland can be seen in the growing number of stations. As of March 23, there are 32 community radio stations broadcasting in Scotland. It was almost double the number a decade ago, and many of them were quite rightly name-checked in the course of proceedings today. According to a recent study published by the University of Northampton, there's a high level of trust amongst listeners. People act on information provided. Significant numbers of listeners have been directly helped in employment, in health, and in other areas, thanks to the information heard and trusted on local community radio. And these small, usually volunteer-led organisations provide a vital resource not only for the local communities that they serve, but also to the Scottish music industry by providing a platform for emerging artists. That's why I'm delighted to congratulate Crystal FM on their second year running as the best community radio broadcaster at the SME News Scottish Enterprise Awards. The accolade is hard-earned, with the station running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, including original and locally produced output, with important objectives including facilitating discussion, providing training and strengthening links within the community, and as we have heard, even as far away as Kirkcaldy. The Scottish Government recognises that culture as communities should respond to the ambition, need and challenges of our respective communities, and Crystal FM Penicuik have demonstrated that they are doing just that. Our culture strategy makes clear that our ambition is for everyone in Scotland to experience culture and the empowering potential that it holds for communities across the country. And we can all acknowledge culture's unique power to inspire, to enrich, to transform our lives, not only as individuals, but also for the collective well-being of our communities. The Scottish Government strongly supports broadcasting and the important role that the distinct and essential services provided by broadcasters have in Scotland in relation to our audiences and the creative sector. And we engage closely with the media regulator Ofcom to ensure that Scottish interests are fully considered. And this week, indeed, I met with Melanie Dawes, the Chief Executive of Ofcom, to discuss their future plans in Scotland. I value Ofcom's initiatives to improve and support community radio, ensuring that stations can focus on delivering social gain for their target communities. And I'd also like to take this opportunity, as has already been mentioned by Jamie Green, to encourage those with an interest to respond to Ofcom's consultation on the key commitments for community radio. As set out in the Building a New Scotland paper on culture, nearly 9 in 10 of us listen to the radio weekly for an average of almost 19 hours, yet broadcasting remains reserved and decision-making on key issues sits with the UK government. With independence, the Scottish Government could build on the strengths of the current broadcasting model and use new powers to develop a broadcasting strategy that better reflects and prioritises the specific needs and interests of Scottish audiences and our creative economy. Today we are celebrating Crystal FM. Colin McCall, station coordinator, and his great team of over 50 volunteers. The Scottish Government values the skills, the kindness, the commitment of our volunteers, and we recognise the difference that they make to people's lives and appreciate all who give their time to volunteer and to make things better for others. Volunteering is the power to make an impact on both society and our well-being, and is one of the most rewarding things that we can do. It makes vital contributions to health and well-being for those who volunteer and those who gain from that support. Volunteering brings communities together and helps people to feel valued and part of something good. It also brings generations together and creates a greater sense of belonging. And we recognise the value of volunteering and the role of community-based organisations to deliver positive social impact. Furthermore, I'm delighted by the fact that Crystal FM presenters are reaching not only their community in Midlothian, but listeners across Europe, North America, Australia and India, demonstrating that Scotland's culture and creative sector is respected the world over for its creative output. Recognising this, today the Scottish Government publishes Inspiring Connections, Scotland's International Culture Strategy 2024 to 2030. This is the first time that the Scottish Government has set out a strategic approach to international cultural activity. And while we supported the sector's international work, this new strategy aims to maximise its potential and provide coherence to our approach. In conclusion, I look forward to hearing what countries will be added to the future list of listeners. I wish the team at Crystal FM all the best going forward, and that the Scottish Government truly values the importance of their work and agrees with the member that radio stations are an important part of local communities, and thanks all involved for their continuing efforts. I'd like to thank Christine Graham again for securing the debate, which has provided me the opportunity to celebrate not only the success of Crystal FM Penicuik, but the importance of community radio right across Scotland. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Cabinet Secretary. That concludes the debate, and I suspend this meeting until 2:30 p.m. Thank you.